Good morning, Saints. How are you doing today? I am so glad to be with you on this Memorial Day 2020. Wow, God has been so good to us. Amen. A special day, a day that we recognize and realize and honor all those who gave their lives for our country, our freedom, and thank the Lord for so many people who were willing and able and who paid the ultimate price. You know, I believe with all my heart that a country should have Memorial Days, and we should be thankful and realize those who gave their lives for our country. And I'm going to talk more about that in just a moment. But I'd like to also thank all the good folks for yesterday. What a great day in God's house. Somebody was saved. The altars were full. The music was fantastic. The testimonies were great. Brother Bradley did us a great job. He encouraged us. Look at that man, 95 years old. He told me he's going to live till he dies. You know what? I think if there's ever a sermon that needs to be preached to all of our folks is we need to live till we die. I know some who are already trying to die before they even get there. You know, oh me, oh my, and the whole world just has to cater to them as they bow down to them because they're dying. And you know, they're not really dying, but anyhow, that's just the way it goes. I just appreciated the testimony of a 95-year-old man boldly proclaiming that he's going to live till he dies, and that's how I want to go. I want to live till I die. I don't want the devil to get one extra day out of it. I want to live the whole way. Well, anyways, it was a great day. Great dinner. Oh my soul, those ladies did such a good job with the dinner. The chicken, two pieces of chicken, some mashed potatoes, and some green beans, and a salad, and two brownies. That was quite a dinner, and a glass of lemonade. It was excellent. It was great fellowship. It was good being around the saints of God and just seeing people and hearing their voices sing, and the piano and all that was going on, all the instruments. It was great being in the house of God yesterday, and I thank God for his blessings and thank God for what he is doing here at Landmark Baptist Church. I believe our best days are ahead of us, and I just thank the Lord that he's going to go with us through these days, and I really believe with all my heart that there were some sincere commitments yesterday as we talked about denying ourselves and taking up our cross and following after Jesus. I think it's an important time for us to realize and for us to do that. So thank the Lord for the blessing of yesterday. And now we come and we put our attention on today. Today is a somber celebration, but at the same time, it's a victorious celebration. Because, you know, we think about the sacrifice that's been paid for us to enjoy our freedoms. God has blessed us with men and women who lived outside of their lives, who gave, who saw the bigger picture, who willingly gave their lives for our country. And I believe with all my heart we should have memorials, and I think we should give tribute and honor and respect, appreciation, gratitude, and love to those who gave their lives for us. Thank the Lord for them. You know, I'm reminded in the book of Hebrews, chapter number 11, verse number 4. Here, Heather will put it right on the screen for us right here. Look what it says. It says, "By faith, Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, by which he obtained witness that he was righteous, God testifying of his gifts. And by it, he, being dead, yet speaketh." Look at those last four words there. Being dead, yet speaketh. Being dead, yet speaketh. I think when we come to this Memorial Day, we realize that those who gave their lives for our country still speak. Yeah, we visit those memorials, which we should, and we hear their voices. It was amazing that year that the Vietnam Memorial was over here at Veterans Park, and we took the school, and boy, those young people, they would go up to it and look into it and see the reflection on it, and you know, some people that were there had some relatives that were on that wall, and how powerful a moment was, and you know, definitely they still speak. They still speak to us, and it's an important time. The Memorial Day was started in 1868, just right after the Civil War, as we begin to honor those who died in that great conflict. And then after that, it was for all those who died in the American wars to give us the freedoms that we have and we love. Memorial Day has grown into a very solemn recognition of all that they have done, and we thank the Lord for it and what they're doing. You know, as we think about it, we're to remember, and I was thinking about some things. What can we remember about these? First of all, I think we need to remember that, these were lives, and it was the sacrifice of a life. Why, when we go by, and Sherry's dad is buried up there at National Cemetery, and we go there, we've been there about three times now, and as we go up there, and we go and down that last, you have to go down the last row, and almost to the very last row as you go back, and we see so many who died in 1941, 1942, 43 and 44, and right away you begin to realize that these were people who died in the military, in war, and some of the things that they would have incurred during fighting for our freedom. It was a life that they gave up. They gave up their hopes. They gave up their dreams. Why, I'm 62 and I still have dreams. Can you imagine the dreams of a 19-year-old or 20-year-old young guy or young girl, how that they've got dreams for what they want to accomplish in the future and the things that they'd like to see? And my soul, they sacrificed their hopes and their dreams. Not only that, they sacrificed their families and their families' sacrifice. You think, I'm going to tell you something. Family is so important. As we will see tomorrow when Jesus goes into the house of Peter and sees his mother-in-law. Families was a thought. Families were conceived in the thinking of God Almighty. God's the one who designed the home and the family, and so it's a God thing. And these people that die in these wars, they are saying goodbye to their families, and their families are saying goodbye to them. I think we need to remember them as well. And then I think all the potential that we lose, and we have to remember those things. I think it's important that we remember those things. I think we need to remember the cause for which they died. They died for freedom. They died so that you and I breathe it, because it may not last long. The Democrats may come into office this year, and if they do, we'll be in a lot of trouble. But right now, let's breathe that free air. Let's breathe that freedom and enjoy the freedom that God has given us. Boy, but you know what? God has given us the freedom, but God has sealed it, and God has used these warriors to pay for our freedom, and thank God for their willingness to do so, you know, and their love for others. You think of not only their, when you think about the cause, not only was it the cause for freedom, but also the cause was their love for others. They loved others, and they gave their lives to protect, defend others, and thank the Lord for it. And then not only that, I think we should remember to live a life that is worthy of the great sacrifice that they made. Folks, listen, I'm going to tell you something. Memorial Day is a special day. We should be thankful, and we should remember. But at the same time, we should be challenged to look at our lives every day and to realize that I've got to live a life that is worthy of the sacrifice. I'm going to tell you something. When America forgets to live worthy of the sacrifices that were given for her to have the freedom that we enjoy, America that we know will be gone. Listen, let's be thankful. Let's be thankful for those who died, and let's live lives that are worthy of the gift that they gave. Heavenly Father, we love you today. And Father, this is Memorial Day, and we think about how that being dead yet speaketh. Father, help us to realize one day that all of us will be dead, Father, and our testimonies will still be speaking. Father, we pray that it'll be a good testimony, a testimony that'll be glorifying to you, a testimony that would be encouraging to others. Lord, today we do remember those who died for our freedoms. We pray, Father, Lord, that you'd bless their families. Lord, somewhere there's a mom's son or a broken-hearted mom, a broken-hearted dad because a daughter or a son will not be there. There's children today, Father, that are living without a parent because of the ultimate sacrifice that some have given. Lord, there's some who have lost a spouse. And Father, help us not to take lightly. And Father, help us with much appreciation, determined to live our lives worthy of the sacrifice that was given. For we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. You think about it. God bless you. Amen.